Well, I think I got it figured out, folks. The Jack MIDI using Jack Audio. It's pretty sweet. I gotta say, our buddy Troy, you might have seen him comment below some of my videos. Our dearest friend Troy, what a swell fella he is. He helped me out with this a little bit. He's been emailing me information and stuff like that, and it turns out it's not actually all that difficult to hook up the whole MIDI connection thing with using Jack Audio. And by that I mean creating the ability to bus MIDI out of, say, Bitwig and into Reason, like we're gonna do here. And, or I mean, you can go out of Bitwig and into Ableton, and we'll probably get into some of that too. And I'm gonna show you how we did it, and you're gonna be surprised actually at how ridiculously easy it turns out to be. Okay, let's start the show. Okay, so you've got your Jack Audio, you've downloaded it, you've installed it, you've restarted your computer, and now you've gone and you've looked for this icon right here, Jack Pilot, and you've opened it up. Now, don't click start just yet. If it's your first time, you're gonna have to go to preferences and set up a few things. In this case, we kind of took care of the audio in a previous video. In this case, you just want to make sure that activate MIDI is turned on right there. Okay, boop boop, right there, turned on. Okay, so click start, and it's gonna do its thing. Beautiful. And of course, you know, routine. You gotta go to sound preferences, select Jack router. There we go. And let's go ahead and open up Bitwig. Come on, Bitwig. There we go. Okay, so in this project, if you watched the previous video, then you'll recognize this. I basically just created an instrument track with nothing on it. And in here, I just took an empty MIDI region and I just drew in a bunch of notes. Like that. And so there we go. And I've selected this Command L and I've looped it. And so now we can just play it over and over and over again. And that way we can work on kind of setting up the MIDI as we go. Okay, so why don't we open up Reason as well? Alrighty. So inside of Bitwig, let's organize this stuff a little bit first here. Let's open up Bitwig. We'll put Bitwig on its own screen and we'll put Jack Pilot in between the two. You know how that goes. Okay, so here we go. We have Bitwig, we've got some MIDI data. It's on an empty instrument track and we're gonna send it out of, well, let's see here. Grab a hardware instrument and set it out of virtual one. And the reason why it's virtual one is if you click on routing, now because you enabled MIDI, you'll see it's here in here, and you'll see that capture one and playback one. Well, those are the virtual MIDI buses that Jack Audio has gone and created. And inside a DAW, they're called virtual one and two, like that, see? So essentially you're gonna click this and then double click that and then bazinga. I hate that word. Why did I use that? They're connected anyway. And then capture two and playback two, and now they're connected. Because here it shows you what's connected to what. Like if I click playback one, it's saying that playback one is connected to capture one. So that's good. They're set one to one. See, two and two. Beautiful. Okay, so now inside Bitwig, we have virtual one selected, and that looks all good. We can see the yellow dot there, the yellow light is lit up, and it's sending out bus virtual one. Okay, so let's go on over to Reason here for a sec. And because of how my computer works, I have to delete all these. Yep, and bring in a synthesizer. There we go. And I'm gonna click on MIDI. Look, virtual one, and I'm gonna send it to Thor input. So let's go over there and see if it works. Well, it does, and it's basically as simple as that, as it turns out. The only thing I wasn't doing before was connecting the two of them, which was stupid of me. Like, I should have known. I just assumed that they were connected, and that was just, it was just dumb of me to do that. But it's also worth mentioning, because I didn't mention this in the last video, that Virtual 1 has 16 channels on it. So you could, in theory, have 16 different instruments just playing through Virtual 1, and then Virtual 2, of course, you get another 16 channels, okay? So it's an ass load. That is just, that's a ton of instruments that you could play on there. And quite simply, there you have it. So we've effectively connected the two programs. So your question might be, well, how do I get more of these going? And that's a pretty solid question. Let me just show you Ableton first, okay? How you would connect Ableton and Bitwig. So let's go in here. Let's close up Reason. Now I don't want to save, but I do want to open Ableton. Come on, Ableton. There we go. That's pretty quick. And it's going to get rid of some stuff here. Okay. And so basically, you can see, open this guy up, Virtual 1 and Virtual 2 for inputs. So you can turn them all on here. There we go. So now we're reading and outputting through Virtual 1 and 2, if that's what we so choose to do. And so if we go here, there's Virtual 1. We record enable and go back over to Bitwig and hit play. Look at that. We're getting MIDI. Beautiful. So that's pretty easy. So if you were wondering how you would get more of these, say 16 channels times two, it just isn't enough channels for you. Say you have 64 instruments that you want to run from DAW to DAW. And that's one, I commend your spirit because that's insane. But two, just for shits and giggles, why don't we add a couple more of those in? Well, it's pretty simple. Let's just go over to Jack Pilot and open MIDI setup. Okay, another way that you could do this, let me close this, is click on the spotlight search and just type MIDI and hit enter. And that's not what I wanted. I'm going to click window and MIDI studio. So you can double click on IAC driver and turn this device online. And here you can create as many of these as you want just by hitting plus, and then you can double click to name them. Me, I don't need more than three. I kind of made three. Two for shipping MIDI tracks around my computer, and one for syncing the transport between two DAWs, so that when I press play and say Bitwig, it'll trigger playback inside of Ableton. So you can do that, and that's fine and well. You can apply that, exit it, and I might have to restart this, but let's just have a look. No, so there you go. So capture one, capture two. The naming is kind of screwed up. That's one thing that I'm not a big fan of, is the naming. So you got playback one and capture one, and then you can just go and set these so that each one is connected to each other. See that? All right. So playback one and playback two, or capture one and capture two, are basically virtual one and virtual two that we created earlier just using Jack Audio. And then the three remaining ones, IAC driver, bus one, two, and sync, and here are called playback 3, 4, and 5, which is strange. And that's what I mean by the naming's a little screwy. So you just kind of have to remember what you did. If you need more than two channels and you use the IAC driver to create more MIDI buses, then you're going to have to deal with the fact that the naming system is a little bit screwy. But basically, in a nutshell, since again we've connected them one to one, like I've connected 4 to 4, 3 to 3, so on and so forth, now I can choose, say, IAC bus 1, go over to Ableton, and I have to configure it, turn all these on, and in here, IAC bus 1, and now when I hit play, ta-da, you're getting MIDI. So essentially, that's it, folks. That's all you really need to know in this whole fiasco. In the end, all I had to do was connect the two of them, and it would have worked just fine. And I don't know why I didn't do that a lot earlier, but thanks to Troy, who made it possible for me to realize my own dumbassness. then there you go. So you can thank him for providing you with the ability to ship MIDI around your computer using Jack Audio. Okay? All right. I hope that did something for you. I can feel you all thinking about how you're going to use this right now. And that's good. You should, because it's a pretty handy tool and it's free. Like, you never get things for free nowadays. Like, a glass of water costs like $600. No, it doesn't. It doesn't. That was a stupid analogy. But you know what I mean? So it's free. Get it. Use it. Enjoy it. Work it out. And let me know how it goes. So if you have suggestions for future videos, dump them down below in the comment section. Or you can email me. If you have projects you want to send me, I'll remind you that I'll take those now. And you'll see them at some point come up on my YouTube. I'll add my thing to them. And we'll see. Okay? All right, kids. Be good to each other. We'll see you in the next video. Ciao.